audience, welcome to the Soldiering for Dummies mini-series. Each military topic we discuss here is called a volume, and we'll have one or more videos devoted to its comprehension. Today's volume will be devoted to exploring the infantry field called Combat Techniques of Fire. Since my videos are based on the official U.S. Army manual, this field will accordingly be broken up into a number of sections, each section composed of a number of chapters. Today we'll be covering Section 1, the Introductions. Introductions covers two chapters, Characteristics of Fire and Classes of Fire. Let's begin. Chapter 1, Characteristics of Fire. A. Trajectory. All projectile weapons experience something called bullet drop. The further away from the gun barrel your bullet travels, the closer to the ground it will be tugged down by the Earth's gravity. Depending on the elevation of the weapon, the area your bullet drops into, an area called the beaten zone, will change. Aiming at 0 degrees, or flat to the ground, will yield your weapon's nominal range. With the M249 machine gun, depending on the terrain, this nominal range is about 300 meters. By aiming the muzzle of your weapon higher, you move the beaten zone further away. By aiming the muzzle of your weapon lower, you move the beaten zone closer in. With this truth in mind, an infantry soldier and his weapon can employ a surprisingly large number of different firing patterns to obtain hits on the enemy. B. Maximum ordinate. This is the highest point the trajectory reaches between the muzzle of the weapon and the base of the target. It always occurs about 2/3 of the distance from the weapon to the target. Thus, when firing at a 600 meter distance target, your maximum ordinate occurs at 400 meters. The maximum ordinate increases as the range increases. So if you move the beaten zone further ahead, you move your maximum ordinate higher up off the ground. At 600 meters, the maximum ordinate of the M249 machine gun is 1 meter high. If any midgets are standing between you and your 600 meter target, they're in for a big surprise. C. Cone of Fire. When several rounds are fired in a burst from the M249 machine gun, each round takes a slightly different trajectory. The patterns these rounds form on the way to the target is called a cone of fire. This is caused primarily by vibration of the weapon and variations in ammunition and atmospheric conditions. D. The beaten zone. As we explained previously, this is the elliptical pattern formed by your bullets striking the ground or the target. The size and shape of the beaten zone varies when the range to the target changes, or when the weapon is fired on different types of terrain. For example, on uniformly sloping or level terrain, the beaten path is long and narrow. As the range to the target increases, the beaten path becomes shorter and wider. When fire is delivered on terrain sloping down and away from the weapon, the beaten path becomes longer. When fire is delivered on rising terrain, the beaten path becomes shorter. The only thing that is not affected by terrain changes is the width of the beaten zone. The width remains constant. E. Danger zone. This is the space between the weapon and the target where the trajectory does not rise above 1.8 meters. This includes the area of the beaten zone. When the M249 is fired on level or uniformly sloping terrain at a target less than 700 meters away, the trajectory will not rise above the average height of a standing soldier. That means any human standing between you and that minus 700 meter aim point are guaranteed to be hit by your rounds. But when targets are engaged on level or uniformly sloping terrain at ranges greater than 700 meters, the trajectory will rise above the average height of a standing soldier. Therefore, not all the distance between you and your weapon is danger space. Chapter 2, Classes of Fire. A1, Grazing Fire. Grazing fire occurs when the center of the cone of fire does not rise more than 1 meter above the ground. When firing on level or uniformly sloping terrain, the gunner can obtain a maximum of 600 meters of grazing fire. A2, Plunging Fire. Plunging fire occurs when the danger space is confined to the beaten zone. Plunging fire also occurs when firing at long ranges, from high ground to low ground, into abruptly rising ground, or across uneven terrain, resulting in a loss of grazing fire at any point along the trajectory. B1. Frontal fire is when the long axis of the beaten zone is at a right angle to the front of the target. An example is when firing to the front of a target. B2. Flanking fire is firing at the side of a target. B3. Oblique fire is when the long axis of the beaten zone is at an angle other than a right angle to the front of the target. B4. Enfilade fire is when the long axis of the beaten zone coincides or nearly coincides with the long axis of the target. It is the most desirable type of fire with respect to the target. Because it makes maximum use of the beaten zone, the target will be fully saturated with gunfire, and you can wipe them out with a single burst. Enfilade fire can be directed at either the front or side of the target, as you can see from the two pictures on the right. C1, Fixed Fire. Fixed fire is fire delivered against a point target when the depth and width of the beaten zone covers the target. Fixed fire also means only one aiming point is necessary to provide coverage of the target. C2, Traversing Fire. Traversing fire is fire distributed in width by successive changes in direction. The gunner selects successive aiming points throughout the width of the target. These aiming points must be close enough to ensure adequate coverage, but not so close as to waste ammunition. C3, Searching Fire. Searching fire is fire distributed in depth by successive changes in elevation. The gunner selects successive aiming points in depth. The changes made in each aiming point will depend on the range and slope of the ground. C4, Traversing and Searching Fire. Traversing and searching fire is fire distributed in width and depth by successive changes in direction and elevation. Combining traversing and searching provides good coverage of the target. Adjustments are made in the same manner as described for traversing and searching fire. C5, Free Gun Fire. Free gun fire is fire delivered against targets requiring rapid changes in direction and elevation that cannot be applied with the T&E mechanism. To deliver this type of fire, the gunner removes the T&E mechanism from the traversing bar on the tripod, allowing the weapon to be moved freely in any direction.